Hello everyone, Happy New Year. I hope you had a great holiday break and ready to start a new year with a fresh mind. Designing responsive web used to mean endless breakpoints, duplicated layouts, and way too much time fixing mobile issues. In today's video, I will share with you how I built responsive website in 2026, 10 times faster. Before I jump in, I share everything about design and tech on my YouTube channel. If you're interested on this type of content, please hit the subscribe so you won't miss any of my future content. In 2026, responsive web design isn't about designing desktop first and fixing mobile later. It's about building systems, components that adapt automatically to content, screen size, and context. That is why my workflow today is component-driven and powered by tools that understand responsiveness at a structure level, like Wix Studio. Have you ever tried to browse a website on your mobile phone and you have to pinch, zoom, and scroll so that you can read the text? That frustrating experience is likely a result of non-responsive design. So responsive design is a web development approach that automatically adjusts their layout, images, and content to provide an optimal viewing experience on your device, from desktop, tablet, to mobile phone. It is about creating a single, flexible site that functions well across different screen size and orientations. So in today's mobile-first world, responsive web design is not just optional, it is a must to create a positive user experience. Okay, so let me show you my workflow. So my first recommendation is don't start from a blank canvas. You know, in Wix Studio, I start with responsive web design templates that already have solid layout logics built in. You know, templates are not shortcuts, they're accelerators. When you browse those extensive library of different templates, remember that you're not just seeking for aesthetics or visual, but choose the template based on how it works, such as the flexible grids, scalable typography, and reusable component. In my case, I'm looking to start an e-commerce website to sell home decor stuff. And as I browse, this template caught my attention. It has the vibe that I'm looking for, like a warm, vibrant color that still provides that cozy, personal touch that has a strong visual presence with minimum amount of text. It also have the section, which seems like a perfect template for me to showcase the products. As we browse this template, you know, there are options you can switch the screen size on the top. Like for example, 1001 pixel and above to a tablet, 751 to 1000 pixel. And you can see the mobile version as well that is set to 320 to 750 pixel. Overall, I like the design and the grid system that I see in this template. I'm just gonna click on edit template and start creating my own website from there. After some work, here is the e-commerce website RC that I created using the template we looked at earlier. So let's take a first glance. It has a homepage starting with a row of three hero images, some headline and a call to action button, followed by a large image and the bestseller products. There's also a section featuring the new collection, which has a button that users can click to explore more. And the next thing I wanted to share with you is breakpoints. Breakpoints are screen size ranges representing the possible screens and devices that people tend to use. In the editor view, at the top bar, we have desktop, tablet, and mobile, the three different versions. If you wanted to add more, you have this option to customize the breakpoints. The default setting for desktop is 1001 and up. For tablet, it is set to be 751 to 1000 pixel. And for mobile devices, the breakpoint is set to be 320 to 750 pixel. If you wanted to add more breakpoint, you can just go ahead and click here to customize it. So for example, I want you to have a breakpoint for even larger size of the screen that measures at 1201 and up. Once we have that added, you will see that there is an additional icon here added to the original three, that now we have a design space, which we just set up for the largest screen. No matter which views you are at, you have this option to just drag this handle so you can see how responsive or how the design of the screen will look like. And if you want to make any adjustment of the screen size, you can always edit it from here and click apply. So a breakpoint that a user sees depends on their viewport size. For example, an iPad user that using a screen at 1024 pixel width will see this desktop breakpoint version of the design that is set to 1001 pixel and up. This also varies with portrait and landscape mode, as each mode has different screen widths that may fall into different breakpoint range. Okay, now let's take a look at this section and learn how to set a responsive behavior of different components. So here we are looking at a desktop view, which seems fine, that has a headline, new collection, followed by this paragraph and a call to action of explore. However, when I switch that to the mobile view, you will see that the tags are kind of messed up with overlapping elements and some misalignment between the title and paragraph. So how do we fix this? First of all, let's go back to the desktop view. If I drag to resize the screen, you will see that right now, everything just scales down as I adjust the screen size to smaller. So one thing I'd like to change here is to set this text area to wrap. So you can select this area, open the inspector panel. You will see this area called responsive behavior, that you have this drop-down menu to set different type of responsive behavior as you want for certain element. And for text, you have the option to switch it between scale proportionally, custom scale, to wrap, fixed, or hug. So here what I want is to set it to wrap. Once you have set it to wrap, as I resize the screen, you will notice that the tag started to wrap around. However, there is a problem that as I drag, you will see this explore button start to collide with the tags above. So how do we fix that? There's something that really important in Wix Studio is called stack. Stacks automatically arrange the elements vertically or horizontally with the consistent spacing. It prevents overlapping or simplifying the responsive adjustment. Here, what we're going to do is select the title, paragraph, and the call to action, this all three element, and click on the stack button. Now it turns into a stack which has this standard spacing set between each element. If you want to make any adjustment, you can just click inline, adjust the number, set it to your preferred spacing. Now that we have the stack set up, if I continue to drag and resize, you will realize that there's no longer overlapping because it keeps the spacing we set between each element that helps you avoid issues such as overlapping. So now let's take a look at the mobile version. Awesome. It seems like the issue we saw earlier got fixed automatically because what we set up in desktop, the behavior, is automatically carried over into the mobile version. So that really is a big time saver once you have the responsive behavior set in one surface, as we looked at in desktop. You don't have to repeat the settings in other devices. It carries over the settings such as stack and the wrapping responsive behavior that we set up in the other surface. Keep in mind that this is something that only carries over from the larger surface to the smaller ones, but not in the opposite way, which means if you're making change in the smaller devices, it's not gonna automatically reflect a change in the larger device. I would just recommend you to make the updates in the larger surface of the screen and then make necessary adjustment if you need in the smaller devices. So next, let me share with you how to create some fun interactions like scroll triggered animations. On the landing page, you know, as I scroll, it feels pretty static. So I want you to add some fun interactions or animations to this image that is scroll triggered. So basically means as I scroll past this content, show some animated effect to the image itself. So how do we set this up? Let's go to the editor view. So once we have the image selected, you can go ahead and click on this button called Animations and Effects. And here you will see a range of animations and effects you can set for different kind of movement triggered by entrance, hover, click, scroll, loop, or mouse effects. So say that here we're trying to set up the scroll triggered animation. I will just go ahead and click on scroll and the add button. Here you will see the options. First of all, the animated elements. And here all we want is the image itself. And then you can select the animation type for in or out. And below, you will see this huge variety of different animation that you can select. For example, fade, move, expand, shrink, which is what we want. So I'm going to click on that. And now let's switch to the preview and take a look how it works. There you go. Now we have this fun scroll triggered interaction. So when a user browses a website and scroll, they will see this fun shrinking animation of the image. Okay, now that we have added this scroll triggered shrinking effect, if you want to make any adjustment, you can just click on adjust animation. That will give you those advanced settings such as the scaling, speed, and animation area that you can continue to customize the animation to what you want. So the next thing I wanted to share with you is responsive AI. We have been hearing AI a lot. How could AI help us in making designs responsive? Let's take a look. So here we're looking at the mobile version of this website I created. I think the desktop version looks fine to me, but for the mobile, it feels a little too much, especially if I'm on a smaller screen, that having three images all stacked in the top area. And also you will see that the font size below seems a little bit off to me, where the headline is smaller and the call to action and subtitle are presented in a more prominent way. How can we fix that? Of course, one option is you can go ahead and make adjustment for the individual component. But here, let me show you a really powerful feature called responsive AI. So first of all, let's just click on this section and you will see this icon look like sparkles is for responsive AI. Let's click on that. So here is where you can get a responsive section on mobile with AI. This is something once you have the design ready for the desktop, you can use responsive AI to help you generate the mobile version. And then you can review, apply, and make adjustment. Let's test it out. I'm going to go ahead and click on generate mobile. As you see, it's making progress in the background by adjusting the mobile layout live. And there we go. This is the result we got. It works much better. As you see, it readjusts the layout to show the three image at full width, one below each other, that followed by the headline in a larger size and the subtitle along with the call to action. I think this works a lot better. So I'm going to go ahead and click on apply design. And there you go. We have an enhanced version of the mobile design created with the help of responsive AI in just a few seconds. So once you have your design ready, you can go ahead and click on preview, where you can get a preview of how your website will appear across different devices. And right now we are on the desktop view. You have this drop-down menu that you can switch between the different page breakpoints or see how it looks like on common devices such as iPad or an iPhone. I find this is super convenient. And once you have it, it's ready, and you can just public your website in one click. So this is all we have for today. So we have a look at my latest web design workflow with Wix Studio. And to sum it up, the key things to remember are number one, start with a template. Number two, design a responsive component that can scale everywhere. Number three, use responsive AI to help you further improve the design. If this helped you rethink how to build responsive website faster, please hit the subscribe for more design and workflow breakdowns. And if you wanted to try this workflow on your own, check out Wix Studio and start creating your own website today. There are a lot of powerful features that are making responsive design a different game in 2026. That is all we have for today. If you have any questions, thoughts, please leave me a comment. I would love to hear from you. I will see you next time. Thank you. Bye.